one of the many.
Oh, here we go. Trouble contact and a huge crash. Up in turn number two.
And our hearts were all in our throats when we saw that. Jamie Little, pit reporter for ESPN, also a dear friend of Dan Weldon's, who is no longer with us. In case you're not familiar, he lost his life in that crash you just witnessed. It was 6 weeks ago out at our local track. So thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me. I mean, last time I was here, we were all pumped up about the race, talking about what was to come, and Dan loses his life. And it was the hardest day on the job ever. I was at the track, and of course, knowing him, knowing his family, I had to go to UMC Trauma and report, and it was just an awful day all the way around.
How is his family doing? He has two young sons and a beautiful wife. How are they?
Yes, I guess they're doing the best they possibly can. They live in Florida. I know she went away for the holidays, and actually Dan's sister has moved from England over to live with her and the boys. So they're hanging in there, but he had a great support group, a lot of great friends. So thankfully, you know, people are remembering him. Fans are still calling and writing and telling their stories about him, so it's been great.
Before we get into the event while you're here this week, the NASCAR event, talk to us about some of the changes we could see out at the local track if those IndyCars race again.
Well, next year, as some people may or may not know, there will be a new IndyCar unveiled, and they're dedicating it to Dan, the DW chassis. Yeah. Actually, he led the way in the safety innovations and testing this race car, so it's very ironic. But that car is being unveiled next year, so plans are still in the making for next year's schedule. They haven't announced it yet, and we're hoping that they're going to come back here, whether it's on the oval or road course, we're not sure, but I know a lot of fans, drivers, they would like to come back here and race. It's a great city for racing.
And if it is here again, it'll be a completely different car, so it would not be what we saw
Absolutely, there definitely would be some changes. I mean, I love oval racing. I know there's a lot of fans and drivers that know that we see some of the best finishes ever. There just needs to be some modifications. They're not ruling it out. We could see cars back at the track.
Okay. Well, let's talk about NASCAR after the lap, and it sounds like a lot of fun. This is designed for all of the NASCAR fans, and they get up close and personal with the 12 top drivers?
Yes, exactly. There's so many things going on. You see it tomorrow night. I'll be hosting with all 12 of the top drivers. It's the third straight year, and it's basically no holds barred. I mean, these guys are going off. It's all fan questions, but of course the poking and the prying and having a great time. It's not televised, just radio, so of course they let their guard down and the drivers have a great time. And it's all about the fans. They're all in the audience. There's still tickets available. NASCARAfterthelap.com, $20. It's at the joint at the Hard Rock, and there's events all week long. You can see the drivers up close and personal. Today we'll be at the Fremont Street Experience with all 12 drivers. Actually, Bob Eubanks is going to be here, so it's going to be a lot of fun.
Doing a little newlywed game while you're down
with
there.
With the drivers. Imagine that.
Well, listen, Jamie, we're going to link up all of that to our website at mynews3.com because I know you have stuff going on all week. But thank you for coming in and talking with us, not only about this event, but about Dan and remembering him.
Thank you guys for remembering him. I know you guys have talked about it so much over the last 6 weeks. It means a lot to his fans and his friends and his family.
Well, Jamie, thank you. Let's check in now with Tom Hawley across the studio with a little traffic.
And with some very busy traffic on the southbound 50.